Greetings, fellow Whovians. Hope you're having a good day so far, and happy Valentine's Day. So, we've finally done it. We have finally reached the end of the Key to Time season. Yay! So anyway, let's take a look at the final chapter called The Armageddon Factor. In their search for the final segment of the Key to Time, the Doctor and Romana arrive on the planet Atreus, which has endured a recent bombing by their neighboring planet Zeos, with whom they are at war. The Marshal Atreus is about to launch a counterstrike on Zeos, but the Doctor finds that Zeos is deserted save for the giant computer Mentalis, which is controlling the war. He also discovers that the true opponent is a third planet called the Planet of Evil. Gee, why does that sound so familiar? Ruled by the Shadow. The Shadow, an agent of the Black Guardian, has Princess Astra of Atreus captive, threatening to torture her if she doesn't give him the location of the final segment of the Key to Time, which she doesn't know. After disabling Mentalis, with the assistance of Romana and Canine, the Doctor creates a substitute sixth segment out of Chronodyne, which gives the Key enough power to create a time loop in which to trap the Marshal ship, armed with the missiles for the final strike, as well as the Mentalis control room. On the Planet of Evil, the Doctor encounters an old Academy mate named Drax, who has been employed under duress by the Shadow, but agrees to help the Doctor. The Shadow wants the key for himself, and forces the Doctor to retrieve it for him. The Doctor leads the mute to his TARDIS and opens the door, but is suddenly shrunk to tiny size by Drax, who then shrinks himself using the dimensional stabilizer from his own in need of repair TARDIS. Originally, Drax misinterpreted the Doctor's plan and shrank the TARDIS instead of the mute. Why? The mute returns to the Shadow with the key, but the Doctor realizes why the Shadow has requested it. Astra is the final segment, dun dun dun, and is transformed in front of everyone. Using their diminished size, the Doctor and Stark smuggle themselves into the Shadow's lair inside of the now restored Canine. Drax again uses the stabilizer, this time to return them to their normal size. The Doctor snatches the partially assembled key and the final segment and disappears with Romana and Canine in the TARDIS, assembling the key after dealing with the Mentalis and the Marshal's missiles. The White Guardian appears to congratulate the Doctor on finding and assembling the Key to Time and requests it be sent to him. However, the Doctor, realizing that it's actually the Black Guardian in disguise, dun dun dun, due to a psych of compassion for the fate of Princess Astra, orders the key to redisperse. Enraged, the Black Guardian threatens to kill him. In an attempt to evade him, the Doctor fits the randomizer into the TARDIS guidance system, setting it to an unlocation in time and space, and leaving the Doctor with no idea of where they are headed, and the Guardian being unable to follow. So yeah, there's a lot of heavy stuff going on there, but it's a good thing this season's finally wrapped up in a pretty package with a nice bow on top. Anyway, let's look at some production elements of this story. Working titles for this story included Armageddon. This story was the last that Bob Baker wrote with Dave Martin. Baker's next story, Nightmare of Eden, would be a solo effort. In the original draft of the script, the Black Guardian did not appear at all. He was only inserted in the later drafts by incoming script editor Douglas Adams and producer Graham Williams. So, overall, a nice final ending for this story, and a nice conclusion to this season overall. So, I give The Armageddon Factor 4 Sonic Screwdrivers out of 5. Well, join me next week as we take a look at The Destiny of the Daleks. So, until then, this is Hooping Queen saying, oh my giddy aunt, when I say run, run, of a reverse polarity of the neutron flow. Would you like a jelly, baby? Fantastic! Allons-y! Geronimo! Bow ties are cool, fezzes are cool, and Stetsons are cool.